You may wonder why we use the gene surgery to prevent HIV. Why not another lethal disease? Two reasons. First, safety. Second, real-world medical value. As a scientist and a father of two girls, safety is my number one concern above all else. The gene we choose, CCR5, is one of the best studied genes. In fact, about 100 million people naturally have genetic variations that disable CCR5, protecting them against HIV. They were healthy. Our surgery cut exactly at the start of that natural variation. Decades of clinical trials has tested medicine to mimic that natural variation, including the first gene editing trial in the United States. Well, it proved safe. Also, protecting against HIV requires the simplest gene surgery, which is to remove just a few DNA letters. Correcting a broken gene will help for more diseases like familial cancer or muscular dystrophy. It's more complex. Studies in the US hasn't shown this works well in embryos yet. The second reason we end up choosing HIV as our first target is the real-world medical value. HIV remains a deadly and devastating infection that needs medical advances. About 1 million people died of HIV last year. New infections remain 3 times higher than the UNAIDS target for 2020. No vaccine or cure exists. Taking pills daily from life carry healthy risks. In many countries, discrimination deepens the devastation of infection. Employers might fire people after discovering their HIV status. Doctors may refuse to treat. CCR5 surgery, while not applicable to the general public, it may be valuable to help a few affected and very high-risk families protect their children from the same fate. This led to the national academies in 2017 named vaccine-like disease prevention as an ethical application of gene editing.